communism is nothing but the most successful form of fascism. And the new or the modern left, if you really look at what they're about something quite different than the people who created the Soviet Union. And they're pushing quite a different agenda. And as I had been coming up as an activist and eventually going on my own ways and leaving the Marxist-Leninist group I had been a member of for almost a decade, I began to notice that all along I had been something different. I, when it got down to it, I was a populist. And if you read U.S. history, populism really should be a good thing. I mean, there's a long history of populism in American history. Coming out of the Civil War and the struggle to abolish slavery, there was a populist party. And as the Republican Party moved into being more of a capitalist and a free market party, the mass movement of small farmers and radicals who had fought for the abolition of slavery in the United States, they formed the Populist Party, and they called for the nationalization of the railroads, and they called for the redistribution of land, the fight against the big monopolies, and they fought for an interpretation of Christianity that would favor the downtrodden and the poor and not favor greed and the rich as was being promoted by some of the big denominations in the United States. So populism, it's been widely distorted. And the way you read it in the United States, it's almost as if to be a populist is the equivalent of being a Ku Klux Klansman. That's what we're told. If you're a populist, you want to dangle African Americans from trees and kill them. And that's just not the reality of what populism is. But because any notion of populism has really been abandoned by the left, we're starting to see this demonization of populism in all circles. In the United States, there is a real confusion about how to move forward. And the organized political left is kind of at a loss. You know, during the presidential election, I'm a leftist, I come out of a left background, but I saw Donald Trump speak, and there were many times that he spoke and I applauded. I heard him talk about how, you know, there's this elite that is not loyal to the United States, these international bankers. I applauded when he said that. When he talked about how, you know, in Syria, or in Iraq, and all these countries, we have attacked them, and the result has been terrorism getting stronger, and that the U.S. population has gained nothing from these wars, I applauded when he said that. Now, I didn't agree with Trump about certain issues like immigration, certain issues like empowering the policing agencies in the United States, but in many ways, Trump was better than Hillary Clinton when it came to the concerns that are important to me. Bernie Sanders, he was removed from the race, and we had the choice of Hillary Clinton or Donald Trump. And there were many people who would have voted for Bernie Sanders who voted for Donald Trump in the election. You know, populism is the future. I mean, this future that's offered, and if you want to talk about reorganizing U.S. society to serve the public and to serve the people in the U.S. society, and if you want to question foreign policy in the United States, the second you do that, you're called a fascist. And you cannot do that. To be a communist, you know, one of the right-wing commentators in the United States, he said that, you know, communism is an ideology that could only appeal to those who hate themselves. And I looked at this and I thought, you know, Fidel Castro, does he hate himself? Did Stalin hate himself? But if you look at the modern left, if you look at the people that are going around and protesting against Donald Trump, that makes sense. A lot of them are self-hating, and there's a real worship of weakness in left-wing circles. Anything that is perceived of as weakness or disempowering, that's worshipped. And anything that is conceived of as strength or showing pride in oneself or building up one's strength, that's attacked, and that's said, well, that's fascist. You can't be like that. The first thing that happens to young people when they go to the university and they take gender studies or race studies or queer studies is they're immediately told that, you know, that their identity, the way that they are as a person, is wrong, and they need to learn to hate themselves more. That's the message the left is giving young Americans. Not surprisingly, it's not a very attractive message. It's really not an attractive message. And it's not only for white Americans, I will say. You know, Black Lives Matter, which is this activist group that has been funded and supported by the highest levels of the U.S. political establishment, one of their primary goals is to attack the Nation of Islam, which is one of the most powerful black nationalist groups in the United States. Why? Because Louis Farrakhan is a black fascist. He's anti-Semitic. He has said things about Jews that are not very nice. He's made statements about Hitler. So this is widespread. And what Mr. Dugin has described in his work, which, I mean, is very meaningful and people are reading it all over the world, is very real. And people should engage with his ideas. One of the primary activities that the global elite is engaging in right now is holding back progress, and that this left that they have unleashed essentially is a destructive left. The message that they give is that, you know, people have it too good these days, right? The environment is being destroyed. You know, we can't have people, you know, live more, you know, comfortable lifestyles. That'll destroy the earth, you know. And this notion that that people should live a comfortable life, this is hedonistic, and we need to do more of an ancient Eastern thing. You know, the modern left is very much opposed. To the notion of raising the world out of poverty, and they have this fascination with chaos and destruction. You know, the second that the revolution is victorious, they denounce it, right? Because then it's an autocratic regime, it's violating human rights. But as long as it's just people in the streets breaking windows, smashing things, tearing things down, they love it. You know, all throughout the United States, they are tearing down Confederate monuments, right? And the Confederacy was an awful thing. I mean, not just for African Americans, but for white people. I do not defend the Confederacy. But they're not replacing those statues with anything. Because the notion on the political left is not just that it's wrong to have Confederate statues. The notion is that it's wrong to have statues of anything. One shouldn't be worshiping anything. The idea that you have heroes that you aspire to become, this is wrong. That's the message that's coming out of the modern left that is very carefully funded and controlled. But if you actually read what Dugin has to say, he's on point in many ways.